Stocks are down following a major distribution day. So let's talk to Matt Cheslock to get some market insight, facts, all that good stuff. Matt, yesterday the market sold off. And when I say sold off, we had a lot of distribution. And I'm sure you saw it on the board here at the New York Stock Exchange. Now, what is the difference, though? Because to me, and maybe a lot of other people, it was the same old story. Trade talks are going on. Now they don't. Why that capitulation from the institutions?
Yeah, I wish I could shed some light on it, really, but it'll be kind of hard to really explain it because at the end of the day, there wasn't that much distribution, but at the individual time, as it happened, as we got a report about, you know, trade talks in phase one may not happen this year, we saw an immediate sell-off. I don't know from our end of it if it is much capitulation as there was just lack of buy side at that opportunity. I think the buyers saw, and they've been in this market very aggressively, they saw this as an opportunity to back away and let the market come to them a little bit. So you're going to see a lot more of that toward the end of the year as positions have been either winnowed down or maybe put off till the next year. You're going to see portfolio managers maybe out of this market right now as you approach the end of the year. You don't want to give up any return that you do have. So there's a lot of different reasons out there that are ancillary to what we're actually watching, whether it's an earnings report, whether it's political, whether it's the impeachment, whether it's the trade talks. So you have to be very careful on how you navigate this market now and how much money you're going to put forth over the last month of the year.
Were you surprised to see Target just completely kick ass yesterday when following some really poor reports from other retailers?
You know, it's funny when you see a disparity between a Home Depot and a Lowe's and a Kohl's and a Target. You think they're the kind of the same, right? You know, Home Depot and Lowe's being pretty similar, and Home Depot suffered, Lowe's benefited, right? Kohl's suffered yesterday, and Target just has been doing it the right way. And that's really a measure of how management has gone about the change that takes place from a brick and mortar to one that encompasses the e-tail end of it. And Target's done a really nice job of that, evidently. You know, you see their stock price appreciation. I mean, quarter after quarter, they're coming out with comps that are a little bit better, you know, up 3%. That doesn't seem like a big number. That's a big number.
Same day sales were really positive for the company. Matt, are you taking a look at transportation, the transports index? What do you think about that one?
You know, that's supposed to be a leading indicator of what the market's going to do. You see that can kind of suffer on some days. There's so much that's going into transport right now. You know, mainly, you know, you look at trucking and rails as you talk about this trade war as that progresses. I think a lot of these companies were hoping that phase one was going to be the start of phase two and this would be good going forward. So, you know, am I looking at it any specifically? Not really right now. Yesterday, you know, one of the sectors that was up strong was oil and gas, right? That's a big part of transportation as well, as far as what is actually being shipped. That's strong again today. Maybe you're seeing an end of the year sector rotation into one of the biggest dogs of the year.
Well, that's really funny considering that tonight Tesla is unveiling the Cybertruck. What do you think about Tesla doing that, considering that they've had such problems in the past delivering their ideas?
Well, I mean, he's definitely an idea guy, right? And that's a quality aspect of what Tesla does provide. It may take them years to get up to it, but, you know, you're bumping up against what America does very well, you know, pickup trucks. You talk about Ford, you talk about GM. These are American-made companies that people are buying because they know they're getting a quality truck. So I'm not sure that a guy that's buying a truck wants it to be battery-powered. That's not why you buy a pickup truck, right? There's a bit of machoism that goes along with that. So it'd be interesting to see how many of those he can actually sell.
That's what I was thinking. What will the modern-day truck driver driving a Tesla truck look like? Because I thought the same thing, and then you have Ford being like, yeah, okay, Elon Musk, there's no way you're going to take away from our market share.
Yeah, I just can't imagine, you know, pulling up in a Tesla pickup truck to, you know, a tailgate at the University of Alabama to watch, Roll Tide. So I don't see it. I get where they were at with some of their higher end models, where they were selling them, mainly out west, maybe in China, and, you know, affluent areas, you know, driving a Tesla, you're doing your part to keep the world greener. I'm not sure that you're driving a pickup truck for that same reason.
Well, thank you so much, Matt. That about wraps it up this Thursday. Hopefully we can see some green on the board for all of us out there. Hang in there. That is Matt Cheslock from Virtu Financial on this Thursday.